Welcome to A Game for Your Nightmares. Today we are talking about the history of Resident Evil, the original game, not the series as a whole, not the remake, or the terrible movies, the game that started it all, that one. Resident Evil is known for being one of the first ever survival horror games and bringing interest back into the zombies and pop culture, and it all started as a remake of a game called Sweet Home. If you've never heard of Sweet Home, that's okay, because I hadn't either, and also because it never came out anywhere else except for Japan, so that also does not help. But Sweet Home, you can kind of think of it like water, and Resident Evil is the water mix-ins like Mio or Crystal Light. Water by itself is pretty great, but there is a lot more room to do something cooler, so you add Crystal Light, and bam, you have something that tastes different, and it's got all new colors, and it has a bunch of sugar, and it's so super sweet. Resident Evil took what was there with Sweet Home and made it better. This is pretty much what I'm trying to go for. Resident Evil was supposed to be a remake of Sweet Home and was even proposed by the creator of Sweet Home, Tokuda Fujiwara, and he even looked to his student, Shinji Mikami, and was like, "My young Padawan, you are ready for this." And Mikami was like, "But I'm scared." And Fujiwara was like, "Exactly." With that, Mikami started working on Resident Evil all by himself for 6 months. He worked on art, a script, and concept designs. He looked to several zombie movies for inspiration of what would make a good zombie game. And at first, the game was set to be a first-person action game, but from all his research, he was like, "Wait, that's lame." This also came from the inspiration of the game, Alone in the Dark. Mikami said that if he hadn't found Alone in the Dark, Resident Evil would have been a first-person game. Well, at first, he wasn't into the idea with a fixed camera angle due to it detaching the player from the experience. But this also led to the famous pre-rendered backgrounds and 3D models that Resident Evil is known for today. Ooh, high quality. One more thing that Resident Evil is known for is the Oscar-worthy performances. Believe me, this stuff is as best as it gets.
No. But something's wrong with this house.
Whoa! This hall is dangerous!
Promise. It's good.
Whoa! What is it?
What? Oh! Oh no!
Okay, maybe not as good as I thought.
Oh, Barry!
That was too close. You were almost a Jill sandwich.
You're right. Barry, thanks for saving my life.
Okay, fine. The performances aren't the best part of this game and honestly ruins a lot of the seriousness, but there is a good excuse. So you know how most Americans don't speak Japanese? Well, neither did these guys. And working in Japan with the Japanese team, there wasn't much good communication leading to something that the Japanese thought were good and didn't realize took away from the experience. There were Japanese lines dubbed over most of the game, but Mikami didn't think these were good enough, so the game was released with English voices and Japanese subtitles. Ready for release, Capcom ran into a few issues. Number one, they didn't think it would sell very well, about 200,000 copies. And number two, the title of the game in Japan is called Biohazard, something that Capcom US couldn't obtain a copyright for, so the title was changed to Resident Evil for the US release. Get it? Because they're in a residential house with evil? Yeah, Biohazard is a bit of a cooler title. With international releases, they also had to censor moments from the live-action intro sequence and the iconic Kenneth death scene. While re-releases promised to add this cut content, it was never released in the US uncensored. Finally, on March 26, 1996, Biohazard, or Resident Evil, was released and became an instant hit, selling over 5 million copies and becoming one of the best-selling games on the PlayStation. Critics loved this game, and while the performances and story moments were generally ridiculous, everyone loved the genuine terror of playing the game. The crazy good graphics and the fixed camera angles really engaged players and sucked you into the experience. While Alone in the Dark and Sweet Home were heavy inspirations for the game, Resident Evil stood on its own, becoming a huge hit. It had taken what Sweet Home and Alone in the Dark presented and improved and built upon it in every way. Survival horror games were changed, and several games and series looked to Resident Evil for inspiration. The atmosphere, the gameplay, the sound design, and inventory management were big, and still seen influencing games to this day. The biggest thing this game oozed, besides blood, was the tension that this game built. The fixed camera angles, the tank controls, the limited ammo, tight quarters, interesting music, and the door opening and loading screens were all very unique. All of these things built up fear in the players, never knowing what was coming up next or even if you were going to survive, all helped this game strike fear into the player, and this made Resident Evil something special. One moment in particular I wanted to talk about is the moment with the first zombie. It is such an iconic scene and it really sets the tone for the experience to come. While your first moments in the mansion are relatively quiet, except for that incessant ticking in the dining hall, coming into the tea room to find Kenneth being eaten alive by a zombie was truly terrifying, and seeing it slowly turn its head with blood on the lips really sent chills down your spine and showed the player that this game is not messing around. The uncensored version even shows Kenneth's severed head rolling across the floor. Curse you, censorship! Well, the remake of Resident Evil took this scene over the edge with the update updated graphics, it's even more effective on putting a truly terrifying feeling in your stomach as you just begin to explore the mansion. It's such an iconic moment, and I felt like it deserved a little bit more love, and RIP to my main man, Kenneth. Hell yeah, Kenneth! Not only did this inspire future games, it brought back interest into the zombie movies and other types of zombie-based media. The biggest one for me is Shaun of the Dead by Edgar Wright and Simon Pegg. An episode of the TV show Spaced shows Simon Pegg's character in a Resident Evil-inspired situation. This led to them coming up with a comedy horror movie, Shaun of the Dead. Simon Pegg has said that Resident Evil was the source of their inspirations, and Edgar Wright came up with the famous tracking shot in Shaun of the Dead after going to get milk after playing Resident Evil all night long. This is just one of many examples of the influence that Resident Evil had on pop culture as a whole, and while the series has had its humble beginnings, it has now spiraled into one of the most popular franchises on the planet. With almost 30 games in the franchise up to this point, Resident Evil shows no signs of slowing down. The recent remakes and upcoming Resident Evil 8 has brought Resident Evil back into the spotlight, and it is much deserved. While Mikami himself has moved on to new series, The Evil Within and the upcoming game Ghostwire Tokyo, the future of Resident Evil is looking good. But it all had to start somewhere, and this first adventure through the mansion was an experience that is hard to forget. While this game has been re-released in the form of the director's cut and a fantastic 2002 remake, I have revisited this mansion many times, but it's still truly a very scary experience that is hard not to appreciate. This game actually has aged pretty well, and it's great to sit down with a Jill sandwich and enjoy this horror experience still to this day. It has had a major influence on gaming and pop culture as a whole, and Resident Evil will live on forever in gaming history. Hey, thank you so much for watching the video, I hope you enjoyed it, and you learned something new! So let me know down in the tombs below what did you think about Resident Evil, and while you're down there, don't forget to sell me your soul and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to see more of me, I'm over on Twitch at twitch.tv/gameforyourthoughts, I'm dying to see you there. And if you want to check out more of my game reviews here on the channel, that would be awesome! And thanks again for watching the video, I hope you have a spooky day, and we'll see you next time on A History Of...